In this episode, we'll be discussing a secret that helped the indestructible Roman legions to win their victories over the unorganized crowds of barbarians. The crux of the skill is maintaining the line. If your squadron masters this skill, it'll be an easy task to destroy the battle formation or random mobs of your enemies. You'll have a firm stance to fight from when facing even the most skilled enemy. Don't be fooled. It isn't as easy as keeping a simple straight line facing the enemy. Keeping the line also involves being prepared to switch formations, maintain firing lines, moving to cover injured allies, and isolating enemy tanks, even while on the move. At the pinnacle of this skill, you'll be able to arrive at the designated point as a group, despite different speed values. It requires supreme teamwork when attacking your enemy from behind cover or from the corner of a city street, and it means maintaining your attack even in the face of the enemy focusing down one of your troops. Let's begin with some simple recommendations that will help you even when fighting alone. We'll then move on to group movements and battle formations. Recommendation number one, take a look at the positions of your teammates at the beginning of the battle. Scroll the camera out and try to think about which tanks will be going where and how quickly and what your own destination is. Try to anticipate the ways you'll have to move, where you may have to slow down or stop. Be sure to be courteous and call out your direction in game by text or voice chat. Recommendation number two, try to make a mental priority list of who should be given the right of way. If you're in a heavy tank, try to make way for the speedier light tanks and artillery, or any group that needs to set out very quickly. If they can get there first, they'll soften up the enemies for you, or gather valuable information about enemy movement. Once the timer finishes counting down, start moving. Do your best to thread the most optimal path. Do not damage or be damaged by other players who are moving erratically. Never drive too closely to another tank. You're an easy target for artillery with that much armor in one spot. Recommendation number three, don't try to race up next to your allies and accidentally leave cover or cross their line of fire. If you're a larger tank, you may have trouble coming to a sudden stop and actually pass from cover and into the line of fire. You may also disrupt allied fire and take a shot from a friendly in the side or rear as you suddenly block their shot. If your ally is already spotted, then you might be receiving the enemy shells that were intended for them. Slow and steady. Recommendation number four. If you happen to collide with your ally's vehicle, try not to continue pushing forward, expecting your tanks to magically become disentangled. Stop and move back slowly. Let your ally dictate where they're moving and then decide how to best get around them. If you've been keeping up, all of the episodes of the Tank Academy have been concerned with moving in close formation, thereby allowing all allies to help with firing or cover. Now we'll teach you how to use formations in battle, step by step. Step 1. The first thing to cover is how to advance from your initial position into the proper battle formation. Keep some simple principles in mind. Stay in groups and don't let your allies trail behind, veer off, or get too far ahead of the group. Vehicles by themselves are easy kills. They just don't have enough protection or enough firepower to face the enemy team's formations. Losing even one tank can be devastating against a coordinated enemy. The weakest formation is a single column, also called the loser's column. The loser's column is where one vehicle after another keeps trailing out in a long line. The result is facing the enemy one at a time and letting them destroy your whole team without breaking a sweat. To avoid stringing out, you need to time your exit from a stopped position. Tanks from the back leave first as soon as they overtake the next vehicle. Then that vehicle leaves, and so on. If you aren't coordinated, tanks will simply fall behind and form the loser's column. One of the reasons that forces form the loser's column is an improperly mixed group of vehicles. To prevent this, players must organize themselves based on speed and needs of position on the battlefield. For example, we'll put all the T-110s in a group and direct them to the right or left of the IS-7 group. Next, we'll order the IS-4 squad to follow the IS-7 because they will be the last to reach their destination due to their comparatively low speed. Another thing that can cause a loser's column is the terrain. Pay attention to the roads and obstacles in your way, like fences, trees, rocks, etc. A small but useful thing to remember is that if you follow in the tracks of the vehicles in front of you, you're unlikely to get slowed down. What's more is that it may confuse any eagle-eyed SPG players who are watching for sheared trees and destroyed objects. In conclusion, we must say that it's important to learn and remember the rally points that exist immediately prior to moving into an exposed position. Pull yourselves together before and after any engagement. Step 2. Maneuvering, turning, and regrouping. You must always be ready to focus fire any targets that may appear, and be ready to cover your allies with the lowest amount of HP. General rules to keep in mind, the first tank should drive at the outer arc of the turn. In other words, this tank will be traveling the most distance in the line of fire. So why such a formation? Take a closer look at the battle scene where the team tries to leave cover. Even less experienced players can see the mistake. As soon as one tank breaks cover, it gets tracked and no one is available to cover it. The stopped tank also blocks any hope of a quick return of fire. Now let's compare what happens when the correct measures are taken. As you can see, the tank on the outside is moving just half a hull faster. Its purpose is to receive all the damage from the first volley. It is then immediately covered by the other vehicles. It's now much easier for his allies to perform this task. They continue their movement and get around the corner. Their movement naturally covers the wounded tank and shares the damage among the group. Ideally, every tank should move a half hull faster than their allies. Practice this maneuver for coming around corners and moving again into cover by creating a training room in one of the city maps. Divide into platoons and send them into the streets. Have them run a circuit and perform this action at every corner. Be careful of clipping buildings and debris as it will slow you down and mess up the formation. Ramp up the difficulty by having all of the platoons run one right behind one another, trying to keep the whole group in motion. Make it really hard by taking turns down streets that can't go three vehicles wide. You can't always perform this tactic in peace, so you should try to do it at your maximum speeds. Let's take a look at this tactic on the Himmelsdorf. Rubble keeps players from running tanks three wide, so all of the sudden they're one gun down. One of the main points of this lesson is to learn how to regroup quickly, so you can always have the maximum amount of guns facing the correct direction. Keep in mind that the pair with the most speed should go through the open area first, since they'll be the least exposed. The slower tank is likely to have better accuracy and can cover their allies while taking shots of their own. You may remember this situation from a previous episode of Tank Academy. As soon as the first tank passes, they should drive to the opposite side to make room for the other tanks, making the turn, and then they should all regroup. Notice that their position changed, but their battle formation remains the same, keeping all guns available. Whenever you move as a group, you should always keep in mind the position of enemy SPGs. Don't move your whole group into position to receive massive splash damage. You're an easier target when you're all clumped together. That concludes our lesson for this episode of Tank Academy. Our work for the day is at an end, but yours has just started. Only diligent practice and repetition of the material is going to ready your troops for battle. It needs to become second nature. Our next episode will cover the importance of surrounding an enemy and discuss how to get out of such a tricky situation.